only rock designer when I pop out. Pop out. Pull up in that foreign, then I hop out.
It's your boy Pop, OG Pop, live right here, What's Poppin' Podcast, with the one and only Katie Got Bandz. What's poppin', Katie?
What it do, Pop? What's poppin', Pop?
Reach me, man. What's poppin'? What's poppin'? You hear me?
What's poppin', Pop?
It's a pleasure. Thank you. Number one, thank you. I know you
honored.
Your voice wasn't feeling too good this morning.
You already sound like Dead Man and Them.
And you still made it happen.
My voice was worse than this, though, boy.
So number one, thank you. Number two, again, we appreciate you. We love for you to get out to the people who do love you. You know, our page turned up when I put that I was gonna have you. People sent questions, all type of, ask you this, you know, all type of. They was turned up, they was happy. Oh, we gonna have you. So number one, we love you. And
for
putting the stamp you have put in the Chicago music scene and just in the drill music. So Katie, how does it feel to see a lot of these young sisters, like that young girl that I see that's, you know, moving now. Lil' Kim brought her off stage the other day, Lil' Lola Brooks. To see a lot of them girls, some of them remind me of you, you know, to have such an influence on this new generation. How does that feel to you?
It's a good feeling. I mean, like, to have influence and to inspire others to do what you're doing, it's a good feeling. Like, I don't understand how people would be getting mad. Why would I be mad? Because I inspired you, you know? That's a compliment to me, and I'm a natural born leader, so all the women, not just New York, Chicago, or wherever, because I'm going to rep the crib first anyway, but all the women in the industry doing their thing, I'm happy. I love to see it.
I just said that we had the pleasure to also have Queen Keys through here, and I told her the same thing. Man, the ladies turned up, right? That's a W for all the girls. That little Ice Spice chick, she's turned the hell up.
Yeah, I just don't like the bullshit. Yeah. Like, they try to make us, like, for one, beef is personal. This is entertainment. We don't have to be friends or nothing. When it come down to the business, we could go rock out and go on about your business. Or if you feel how you feel, we could go at it on a song or whatever, like, you know? I just don't be getting it, and people ain't even worth my energy no more. And like, since I've been going through what I've been going through and getting back to myself mentally and spending a lot of time by myself, I be sitting back looking at things, and I'm not a little girl no more. I was a kid. And when I was making the wrong moves or decisions, and I was like a firecracker, you know, nobody set me down. All they did was criticize me, judge me, and all of that, like, you know, but I'm good. But that shit hurt.
It did hurt. You ain't just no artist who you feel too. You want to share any of this? I know Katie's had to go on through a nice little journey for her. You want to share maybe for the people and the listeners, you know, some of your journey to even get to, because I'm going to bring up, I just peeped Nikki threw you on a song, and the fans, as well as myself, want to know what led to the collaboration, you know, to, you know, that situation, and maybe your relationship with Nikki. So if you want to boil all that
shout
up.
Shout out to Nikki.
Shout out to Nikki.
I've been a fan of her since I was in sixth grade. We was, you know, well, how the song happened.
Yeah.
She had put up a post, and it was something with, was it Lauryn Hill or somebody? And she was, it said something about she broke a record from like 1998 or 99. And I gave her flowers. I gave her flowers. I just said, congratulations, Queen. And she had DM'd me a couple hours later and was telling me, like, I know this beat might be a little poppy for you, but give me 8 bars ASAP. I already knew the song because I follow her, you know, when she had just dropped it, that was her single. She was pushing at the moment, and I was like, damn, she giving me an opportunity to get on the song. Like, I started sweating, shaking, crying.
Dope.
I'm sitting in the room, and I'm like, damn. But I wrote her back, like, I'm versatile. I'll get it back to you ASAP. She's like, all right. I hit up an engineer. He told me he could get me in the studio in 2 hours. I jumped in the shower. I called Block. Bro, this is what we've been talking about 10 years. I say, he's here now. He what? She giving me an opportunity to be on her song. I say, I got to come with it in. It's 8 bars. He like, you lying. Because imagine that instrumental was out nowhere, so she sent it to me, you know. I ended up telling my mama. She would start getting too excited, talking too much. I was like, you got to be quiet. I can't tell nobody, you know. You fucking up as going. Because I was excited. I couldn't tell nobody, though. Like, not no closest friends, nobody. If that wasn't nobody a part of my team, they didn't know, you know. I sent her my verse. No, I was in the studio before I made it to the studio. The verse was done. Me and Block was going back and forth on the phone. And I was like, I liked it, but I was like, I think I need to do another one. I'm like, this Nicki, man. Hey, you tweaking, you ain't finna sound like the rest of them. You could talk about fucking a nigga up and fucking a nigga in the same bar like you've been doing, you know. Stay in your lane, don't change. I go to the studio, I lay down the first verse, which is the one that's on the song. And I did the second verse, but it was like, it wasn't Katie. So I'm going back and forth with the people in the studio and they was like, no, you said pull up with that blicky sticking out of the Prada. Submit that. I sent it to her. She wrote back like, oh, bitch, ooh. send the session files over right now. So I'm like, damn, I'm in that line, like, you know. But like a week passed, and then when she put up the little promo clip, my little brother DM'd it to me when she was saying people where they from in the intro. I had commented excited, but I ain't say that I was on the song. So people was writing me. She was like, erase it, don't let them know. Like, I never knew who was on the song. Nothing till it dropped.
But they were hitting you up because they heard you at the beginning. Who heard you at the beginning a little bit?
Who?
You said that you told them to take it off?
No, I had 2 verses. I submitted one, though, uh-huh. The verse that's on the song. But I wanted to submit the second verse, but then when I thought about it, I'm like, that's not Katie. It was just talking too freaky. I don't talk like that on songs, mm-hmm. But I got music like that.
Right.
But that ain't how I be coming. I don't want to rap like them bitches. I got my own lane. They trying to be like me.
You killed it, though.
Thank you.
You killed it.
Thank you. Shout out to all the other ladies who was on the track. They did their thing.
Yes. We were all, everybody, a lot of people were like, okay.
I listened to that song and I
her
was like,
engineer
damn,
was
I'm
like,
really
her I know your engineer was like, yesterday's price is not today's price track.
Because he couldn't upload nothing until the song dropped either. So when the song dropped, he uploaded a video with us in the studio. Because, like, I don't like going to the studio with 50 people no more. See, I was younger when I started. I was 18 years old when I started rapping. No, I was, well, you might as well say 18 because I turned 18 a week later, yeah.
The ladies are definitely in their glow and they shine. What kind of excuse do I mean, and not what kind of advice? Because your advice is different than everybody's advice. You know,
they got to make sure their business is in order. Like, you got to make sure your team is for you. And everybody have to be team players. Like, I done had bogus contracts and people go off of what other people be saying about me. Like, come get your own outlook on me before you go off of what you see on the internet or what you heard. Like, because I put in a lot of work, like, not just for the city, but for myself, for the women. It's already hard being a female in a male-dominated. Well, I'm not going to say no male-dominated field because it ain't nothing that a nigga could do that I can't do. I could, if I don't know how to change the tire, I learn. I know how to take out garbage. Like what? Shit, we the blueprint behind this shit for real. But I would just tell people, especially the young ladies, like, stop trying to get caught up in this street shit with this music. Because this street shit gonna get your ass made an example out of, whether it's jail or dead. For real. Because I rap about street shit, but you don't never hear me singing fuck nobody neighborhood, fuck none of this and that. I been singing fuck the ops before they were smoking on people. So let's start there. I never disrespect nobody neighborhood. They dead people, none of that, even though my neighborhood and two people and all that. I don't find nothing funny about nobody burying their loved ones. Shit, I was just mentally gone for 8 months from losing my friend. Like, that shit a whole another level of pain.
Katie,
there ain't no gas out here. People ain't got a man of their own.
Katie, I like to clean up shit here. I try to give people. Sometimes I know depression and hate comes from the hate. You know, I mean, hate comes from the depression comes from hate. And I know you got people's riding you hard over that GCI shit, right? So, as an artist, you know what I'm saying. As a media person, we know that stuff happens, and there's always three sides to the story. Of what happened. Can you tell the people that do love you, were expecting you that day, you know, what happened?
Let's just start here. Every lesson comes with a blessing, you know? My business went in order.
Okay.
So I can take accountability for that. Mm-hmm. I never received the deposit, and I went hard for promoting Big Jim from the day they called me. Like, my family bought Scat Boxes, Phoenix, everybody. Like, I was too busy worried about everybody with Katie and worried about my business to the point that I wasn't, you know, and I wasn't in my right state of mind. Like I just told you, I had, like, last year I lost so many people and I had a great, successful year. I never really had no time to grieve, but when I lost my friend, in the midst of me preparing for Big Jim, it was days that I was at rehearsal crying, like, but I had to get myself together because I'm stepping in front of kids who looking at me as inspiration, you know, like nobody know like how that shit felt. Like, even when they reached out to me, I asked them to give me a decent slot on the show. I never performed at Big Jim. Shit, I did Summer Jam a lot of times, and I know from reacting off angry emotion, that shit'll cost you. I got on the internet, you know, and said what I said about WGCI, and
the reason I asked Katie,
they said what they said about me on the air. You know, I talked to them, I apologized. But most of all, I owe me an apology because I fucked myself over the most. They weren't offering me shit but $5,000. I spent $3,000 on sprinters just to get 30 kids to the Big Gym, you know? And while I'm outside trying to get in the Big Gym, he was trying to fight my peoples, you know? The kids who I'm trying to take. But it was like in the midst of that, I was praying, I'm God. Show me, like, those who can stay and those who gotta go in the process. Everything, not even just Big Jim, man. That's why it ain't happening. Them people who was bashing me on the internet in the process of that shit, they was gonna do that anyway. They only used me to get in the building and it didn't happen. I was in the building. I went viral, you ain't see it?
We seen you there.
I made my way to the stage. I was like, please, even if I can't perform, let me just say something to the people. They get a kick out of trying to tear me down, but guess what? Can't nobody stop what God got for me.
No.
Like, taught me a lesson, though. Like, I don't have no hate to GCI. I love GCI. WGCI and Power 92 been fucking with me since I first came out. Like, for real, I caught the bus to my first interview with GCI by myself with no entourage. You see, I ain't with no entourage
I'm
with one person.
Who interviewed your first interview? Who interviewed you your first
The
time?
Morning show was, wait, you said which interview?
Your first interview up there that you took the bus to. Which one was it?
I did the morning show.
Did the morning show on GCI? Nice.
You can watch it if you think I'm lying. It's on YouTube.
I did watch the Vlad one you did.
They be trying to get me to try to get interviews and talk crazy about
the reason I asked you, Katie, because I see how bad you got drugged down. And I always like to give the person the opportunity to tell their side and for y'all to know that what y'all do say mean online, that hurt people, you know? That make you go through stuff, you know? And I do want to make an awareness that, you know, people got hearts too, you know what I'm saying? So watch your mouth.
And they fail to realize, like, just think about it. I'm, like, battling with me trying to be better than who I was yesterday, like, childhood trauma, things that I wasn't taught, still learning, but I don't want to dwell on the past. I don't want to look back and be salty. I'm trying to look that way. Like, I could talk about all of that for hours and hours and days and days and days. I learned, though, you know, but even for my own city, the other females was on the internet talking shit like, oh, I should have been at Big Jim, woo, woo, woo. Yes. Maybe you should have. Maybe you could have. Shit, I was even reaching out to Chicago artists trying to bring them out. I was trying to do it for the culture, like, you know, and everybody was giving me excuses, but when they see I got stuff going on, everybody reach out, oh, Katie, can you do this? It costs for me to get ready to come to your event. Makeup, hair, I still have to pay transportation. If I bring my DJ security, they don't think about none of that. Like last year, I was just steady telling everybody, yes, 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 yes. And all of them same people, where they at? But it taught me a lesson. And I ain't taking nothing personal. Business is business, and personal is personal, but I'm not finna keep telling people, yeah, but then they gonna give me the short end of the stick and then want the long end of the stick and then, like, show me. If I'm fucking up, help me. Don't talk down on me.
Katie, during your whole course of your career, you've worked with some amazing motherfuckers, you hear me? From Louis to Nicki. And a bunch of people in between.
Jeremiah, Wale, Yondro, Plaz. I got a catalog. Chicago artists too. Dreezy, Lil Herb, Tink, Amory.
And I bet you she don't listen to rappers either. What you turn on when you get R&B. To go? R&B.
R&B or juke music.
You see what I'm saying? R&B. You can't
if remember. I knew how to sing, they think Ashanti was foolish with Mary J. Blige.
We caught you live a little yesterday in the car singing a little bit.
Oh, yeah, I love R&B. It's just, like, yesterday I was reading DMs and comments that people were saying, like, because they pay attention to, you know, and they was like, damn, I'm so happy you getting back to yourself. It was days I couldn't get out the bed, crying, like, balled up. Can't eat, don't know if I'm coming or going. I felt like my body was just here and my soul's gone. Like, people don't know how that shit feels. Some people do, but.
Katie, I'm at a part now of the show where I'm gonna throw three names at you, right? Three names. I just want you to say, I'm gonna do one at a time. I want you to say first thing that come to mind. Cameron. And the new sports show they got. Have you seen it yet?
Oh, I watch.
So what do you think about it?
I love it. It's hilarious. And it teaches me a lot of shit too. It's funny. I love Cameron.
Okay. They dope.
Yes.
I think it's a dope. Fun. I think it's a dope podcast. What do you think about, I don't know if you've seen it. I'm gonna tell you, I'm gonna put you up on it. I'm gonna put everybody up on it. Who ain't seen it? They shared it somewhere this morning. It wasn't a good look. I think it happened like a week ago. Love City could correct me if I'm wrong. Did anybody catch Noriega and Joe Buttons talking about all these old ass rappers trying these new, they were talking about Trick Daddy cooking shows and these little sports shows. So Joe Buttons and Nori, a Drink Champs, was talking shit. You know, so this morning, Cameron fired back, you know? But I think it's a dope show.
Wait, who was the other person you said, Nori and who?
Nori and Joe Buttons was talking shit about Cameron and them. You know what I'm saying? Cameron
and them. I don't even, like, I don't understand, like, people make a problem out of everything you do. Like, damn, you could be the only person with a podcast?
Mm-hmm.
Like, what's the problem?
Yeah.
I don't look, you don't get to shine throwing shade. I bring light wherever I go, because I be chilling. I don't even like people all in my face. Like, well, it's more hate out here, like. And then they should be trying to show the younger generation, like, what leadership is and coming together, unity, like, what? I don't understand. 100%. So 100%. When you ask me that, that's how I feel about it. I ain't seen it, though, but I watch both of their stuff.
I've had to go watch it.
I haven't seen it.
I've seen the clips made me go.
You forgot when I got up today, I had to get focused for this. My voice was gone.
Nah.
I'm going to go see it, though.
Okay.
And then I'm going to call you.
I think it's pretty dope. Okay.
But I don't like what they said, what you just said.
Yeah, I don't think Nori throwing and Joe throwing salt on them and hating on them. I don't think that was cool, you know, because anybody can't have a platform. They all got different sauce. And you talk about Killer Cam and Mace. You know, they actually came from.
They be dropping jewels, though.
Yeah, they
I learned a lot of stuff from watching people podcasts.
Yeah.
I'm about to start a podcast, and, like, my stuff gonna be, like, basically therapy.
Therapeutic. Mm-hmm. Okay.
I see a therapist now, and I talk to a psychiatrist, too. They tried to prescribe me medication. I ain't taking that shit, but everybody needs somebody. And it's like, some people do not listen when you're venting. Sometimes you just need an ear. Sometimes you need advice, a hug. Some people just listen to respond, you know?
Yeah. And even help you too, channel.
Yeah, because I was holding so much in. It was bottling so much in. It was like, it shut me down. Mm. Like, just think about it. Being a young girl, and you feel like you got a chance. Well, I did have a chance. I still got a chance. And I accomplished a lot. But every time you build your shit up, and then you think you're overwhelmed and try to let someone try to manage you or help you, it backfires. Like, damn, I have not hit a straight run. Manager want to be artists. Like, damn, like, even in the past with people saying, oh, she's late, it was never my fault. But it was, because guess what? When you show up, it's your fault because your name on it, not the manager, you know? But I learned that. Like, I've been trying to show up to shit 30 minutes, 45 hour early. Today fucked up with my voice being gone, because I would have been here too. Yeah.
What you got coming up, Katie? What can we look forward to 2023 from Katie? What you got? You got a podcast you said you're working on?
I don't know if I want it to be a podcast or a talk show.
A talk show. Okay.
But, like, I really want to focus on the kids. I got shows coming up. I'm thinking about starting something with mental awareness and anxiety and stuff.
Dope.
Because I deal with all of that stuff, too. And anxiety is serious. Like, on the way here, on the E-way, like, I had to turn on the air in the car, all type of stuff. Because it's different when you in front of cameras, in front of people, when you on stage. Even though once I start speaking, I'll be okay, but sometimes I don't.
Katie ain't finna get away from me that easy. You got two more names.
You know what?
Jada Pinkett Smith. What do you think about Jada?
I love her.
Okay.
But like, as far as...
Just, you know, I
don't... I love her. The like, first red table talk, like, everything what she's doing, I don't get in people marriage.
Okay.
That's not my business.
Okay.
Because I go through stuff too.
Okay.
But I love her, like...
All right. Okay, last name. I'm glad I would ask that question with Jada. I'd have been all over.
What you gonna say? You wanna be?
No, I ain't gonna do it.
No disrespect, Jada.
I ain't gonna do it. But how about dude who he'd be kind of trending? Let me ask about him. Not the guy who played Creed, but the other guy. Jonathan. What's his name? Did you see the Creed movie?
I've seen the old one, but I need to see the new one.
The new one. This guy plays...
I used to watch TV.
How about Creed, the Creed? Michael B. What you think about him? He's doing a lot of projects right now.
He's doing his thing.
Who left him? Lori something?
Lori.
Yeah. You know what I'm talking about.
You know her name, Lori.
Yeah. He's pretty dope, though.
Yeah.
I was trying to get...
She young. I mean, look. Until you marry, you single, really, for real. Even when you marry, that's just a business transaction, for real. So, she young. I'm young. I'm going to explore it so I can't. Oh, well. For real. Okay. Like, what do you expect her to do? Sit over depressed and back? It ain't worked out with us. I'm finna try something else.
They hit me cool
when men do it, but when we do it, we hoes.
No, I ain't got that.
How am I a hoe? Because our relationship or with us trying to date didn't work out. When you going over here to do what you do, you just ain't showing it. People need to live in a truth. I don't give a fuck what people think about me. I can't wait till I get to 100% of being unbothered. Like, why I don't react to stuff. That's what I'm working on.
You gotta tell us, Katie, what's your favorite collaboration you've ever done with anybody? What's your favorite collab?
See, we've been talking about a lot of that.
It's Nicki. Nicki, of course.
I talked about that forever and it happened. God, real. Manifestation is real. What I want to talk about a collaboration, what I want to happen now. I love Nicki, though, but.
What would your next one be that you would like to see yourself doing and come to light?
Jay-Z, Lil Wayne, J. Cole.
I got to do it. How about younger talent?
I work with any of the younger people. But I work with Yo Gotti. I love Yo Gotti too. Jeezy, Gucci. Oh, yeah. Gucci.
Ooh, could you imagine a Gucci
Glorilla remind me of myself too. Ice Spice, all of them doing their thing.
That's another one that reminds me. Okay.
Who?
Glorilla. Just yeah. Like the little Lola.
I love crew. Like, man, they doing what they supposed to be doing. Shout out to them. You say Lola?
Lola.
Billy B was just up here. Me and Sasha it was Sasha event. Sasha brought her.
Love City had her up at the WGCI thing too.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, look, it's been a pleasure. We wanted to just make sure we showed you love.
I appreciate it.
We love you here.
I love y'all.
A little bit. Yeah, man. Katie in this motherfucker.
Yeah, but DC Vibe at the drop. Shout out to Black on the Track. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Katie got BANDZ. Snapchat, Katie got BANDZ22. TikTok, I don't know how to work it, but Katie got BANDZ773. Go roll up, bitch.
Only fans.
Hey, yo, Jewelry Clinton.
I'm a very freaky girl, so don't bring me to mama's.